This next patient had a PSA of 4 and then a PSA of 5.5 2 months later. They had an mpMRI with a PI-RADS 3 and then targeted biopsy that discovered inflammation but no cancer. 6 months later, their PSA went up to 10. And they want to know what they should do. Should they repeat the biopsy or repeat the MRI?
We're talking about someone that has is being evaluated in what I would consider a more modern sense with an MRI rather than a random biopsy. Historically, men have just gone around the clock and had a dozen biopsies done to make sure there was no cancer. Back several years ago, it was shown that MRIs are better at finding prostate cancer, and people are starting to substitute multiparametric MRI and targeted biopsy for the old random biopsy so they don't get stuck in the prostate so much with these needles. The situation with a rising PSA, I think it just takes a fresh look. Maybe time to get another MRI. Of course, you want to review where was the MRI done and was it read by reputable people? Since we're putting so much reliance on the MRI to make sure we're not missing any cancer. So I would make sure that the MRI was done at a flagship center. Consider repeating the MRI. When people have a targeted biopsy, they that's a skill. And so they have to make sure that the physicians that are doing the targeted biopsy are actually hitting the target. So this new technology, multiparametric MRI followed by targeted biopsy, I think is definitely a better way to go. But the quality control is essential. And people can have their MRIs sent for overread at places like Memorial Sloan Kettering or Cornell or UCLA and make sure that they're not missing something and that they're targeting the right area. Those are the issues I think that need to be reviewed.
So this next patient is 91 years old and is taking testosterone replacement therapy. His PSA was rising to about 13 when he was on the therapy, but every time he gets off, it drops back down to 1. His testosterone is less than 200. He's worried about getting biopsy because of his age, and he's also had a hip replacement, which precludes him from an mpMRI. Do you have any other ideas of how he should check if he has cancer? Because he wants to continue his life and is worrying about threatening it. So first of all, can we deal with the hip replacement and the mpMRI? Can he absolutely not get an MRI with the hip replacement?
So if he goes to a center that has experience doing MRIs in people with hip replacements, they'll probably do something with a 1.5 Tesla MRI and make adjustments, and they can get pretty good images. You can also get a color Doppler ultrasound and look and see if they can find a spot that looks like it's cancerous. I would agree that a 90-year-old doing a random biopsy would be a risky procedure. Targeted biopsies where they just take one or two cores are pretty darn safe. In our own experience, we've seen essentially no infections over a 5-year period just doing targeted biopsies. The point being is that if he has a cancer that could be radiated and eliminated, then he could safely go back on the testosterone if he felt that was important for his quality of life.
Hey everyone, it's me, Alex, and our mascot, Hunter. You can check out his Instagram, Sir Hunter the Dow, at the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and in fact, if this dog high-fives me, high-five! High five. Can you high five me? Thank you. You have to subscribe. Go subscribe to the YouTube channel. He even thinks it's awesome. Also, don't forget to visit our website, pcri.org.